Let me hear you make some Holy Ghost crazy noise right now. Let me hear. With me. Come on, come on, all God's people. Come on, come on, Mike.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Welcome to Start Right Church. We're so thankful that you were able to come up, wake up this morning. Come on, let's put our hands together. Let's praise the Lord. God is good. He woke us up another day this morning. He woke you up another day, allowed you to come here and join us. So we are so very thankful that you were able to join us on this extra special Palm Sunday. I'm pretty sure there hasn't been a Palm Sunday like this in all of time. So I'm hopefully that you are there with your family, your children. If not, this is a great time. Go wake them up, you know, get them up out of bed, bring them down to the tablet, the phone, the TV, if you're streaming to your TV, and let's come and worship the Lord on this Palm Sunday. Amen. I'm looking at Psalms 34, and it says, I will praise the Lord at all times. I will constantly speak his praises. I will boast only in the Lord. Let all who are helpless take heart. Come, let us tell of the Lord's greatness. Let us exalt his name together. I prayed to the Lord, and he answered me. He freed me from all my fears. Those who look to him for help will be radiant with joy. No shadow of shame will darken their faces. In my desperation, I prayed, and the Lord listened, and he saved me from all my troubles. For the angel of the Lord is a guard. He surrounds and defends all who fear him. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, the joys of those who take refuge in him. Fear the Lord, you his godly people, for those who fear him will have all they need. Even strong young lions sometimes go hungry, but those who trust in the Lord will lack no good thing. Amen. And so that was Psalms 34, verses 1 through 10 on this morning. Just letting you know that God is on your side. God is on your side, and he is there with you. Let's just pray for a second. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank and praise your name, Lord. We thank you for just this day that you have given us, another day to come and worship your name, Lord, to focus on you, to dedicate this time and space to hearing, eating, and understanding your word, Lord. I ask that you just bless the word that goes forth. Bless those who are listening, Lord. We ask that you just bless the technology right now of those streaming, Lord. Let no interruptions in the stream go forth. And if they do, give them the encouragement to continue to try to figure it out so they can get back to your word, Lord, so they can get the understanding that you have prepared for them on this Sunday, Lord. We thank you for this Palm Sunday, Lord. We thank you for everybody that is tuning in, that will tune in, that will hear this stream. Let it be a blessing to them, Lord. Bless the word as it goes forth. Let it be nourishing to their bodies, Lord, to their hearts, to their minds, to their spirits. We ask all these things in your son, Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. Amen. And so we're going to go ahead and get our praise on like we normally do. And we're going to go ahead and bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Amen. 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 So, again, we need you to praise and sing along with us. I know you're at home in your pajamas. You're comfortable. You're in your element. So you shouldn't be worried about who is next to you in your house. This is your house. And so invite the Lord into your house. Amen. He should already be welcome. He should already feel welcome. But you can invite the Lord into your house this morning as we bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Amen. So come on and clap your hands, sing, shout. If you got a tambourine, you know, go run and get it out your car. If not, bring it in your house. Get some pots and pans for the kids and let them go ahead and make a joyful noise unto the Lord this morning. Amen. So we're going to go ahead and get that praise. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Let's go. Let's get it. I gave you ample time. Let's get ready to go. Wake up, wake up, wake up, wake up. Let's go. It's time to wake up and win with Start Right. Amen, amen, amen.
Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. No other name I know.
Come on.
Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. No other name I know. Healing's in the name of Jesus. There's healing in the name of Jesus. Healing in the name of Jesus. No other name I know.
There's power.
Power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
There's healing in the name of Jesus. Nobody's like Jesus, nowhere, no how. And that's whether you're in the church house or in your house. You can call on the name of Jesus. His name is Jesus. No other name under heaven can save. His name is Jesus. Jesus. There's no other name that I know. Somebody ought to be happy this morning.
Hallelujah.
Somebody ought to get your praise on this morning. If you know that Jesus is your Lord, your Savior, come on and bless his name this morning. Lord, we bless your holy name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I'm so glad I'm awake now. I got that praise down on the inside, working its way on the outside. Thank you, Lord. Oh, what a change in my life. I just thank God on today. Then we're going to go before the throne room of grace. Won't you go with us? Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. It's time for prayer, everybody. Hopefully you got your praise on. You were able to get your praise on and take your mind off of what's going on in this world right now. But now we're going to go ahead and go into prayer. Amen. And so as we go to prayer, we just want to go to God, just thanking him for everything that he's done for us so far. Lord, we're just thanking you. We want to thank God for what he's done before we come to God with any requests, before we come to God with our needs and wants. We want to take this time and just thank him for what he's done. And I know it could be a little hard in this time right now of uncertainty and this pandemic and the virus and everything like that, but this is just an opportunity to think about what God has done for you so far. There's a silver lining in everything, so to say, and it's about how we look at the situation. Some people could say, I'm stuck at home, but you can turn that to a positive and say, I'm safe at home. You could say, I can't go out to, you know, everything's shutting down, or you can look at it and say, you know, all the essential things are open. Grocery stores, hospitals, things that are going to keep this world running are still open. You could say, you know, nobody's able to talk with anybody. Or you could say, my family is just a phone call away. My family is just a FaceTime, a duo away. My children are upstairs. My husband, my wife, they're safe at home with me. And so it's all about how our perspective on this thing. And as Christians in this world, our perspective is supposed to be sent through the filter of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. And he is our hope. He is our hope in this world. And as on this Palm Sunday is especially important because it begins to mark the end of Christ's ministry on earth, but the start of his eternal reign in heaven. Amen. And so we are so thankful that God, in his infinite wisdom, that Jesus, in his infinite wisdom, even though he knew what was going to happen, people were cheering and screaming Hosanna and were glad because they understood who he was, but he knew that they really didn't understand who he was, his purpose, what he came here to do. And so this is such, it just goes to show that our perspective is so important. It's so important that we don't just look at things for the way that we want to see them, but that we send them through the filter of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. So as we go into this time of prayer, as we go into this time, bring your family close together, husbands, wives, hold hands, bring your children close. And if you're watching us by yourself, just know that you are not alone, that we are touching and agreeing with you in the spirit. For in the Bible, it says where two or three are gathered in my name, he is there in the midst. And he doesn't specify whether we have to be in person or if we're together on Facebook, that we are together with each other right now. We are stronger together. And so we're going to take these prayer requests that we have received thus far. And if you have some prayer requests, you didn't get a chance to email or text it in, drop it with us on Facebook, and we will be touching and agreeing with you in prayer on our Tuesday prayer and on our Friday prayer. So please drop a prayer request on Facebook, and we will be praying with you and your families for those prayer requests that you drop. So right now we're just praying for Catherine Tate, Lord. We're praying that for healing from the COVID-19, Lord. We are praying that you just touch her body. She has contracted the virus, and I'm not sure if she's at home right now or if she's in the hospital, but wherever she is, Lord, we're asking that you just touch her body right now, Lord, that you heal her, that you are still a healing God, that you are a God that can still work miracles, Lord. And so we are just lifting her up right now, Lord. We're lifting her up right now in the name of Jesus, Lord. We're praying for George Golden, Lord. We're praying for James Jackson, for Marsha Skolnick, Lord, for the Reddick family, the Northcutt family, the Hughes family, the Wilson family, the Hillier family, the Scott family, for Ayanna Barkley, Lord, for continued recovery for her, Lord, for the Dilworth family, Lord, the Haslin family, Lord. We're praying for children at home from school, Lord. We're praying for the parents that are stepping in the roles and taking on the teachers' roles right now. We're praying for the teachers that are teaching children virtually, Lord. Give them strength and wisdom in order to keep reaching these kids, Lord, and letting education go forward. We're praying for the health of all of our seniors, Lord. Those that are part of the most at-risk population right now, Lord. We're just praying for their health, Lord. Praying for their safety, praying for their wisdom, Lord. We're praying for salvation, safety, provision, and protection for all of our Start Right partners, members, and their families, Lord. We're praying for the Phillips, the Blue, the Odo, the Wimberly, the Pinckney, the West, Hines, the Walker, Thomas, Jackson, and Williams families, Lord. We're praying for Javon Cole and his family for the loss of his father, Lord. Comfort that family, Lord. Comfort them in the name of Jesus, Lord. Holy Spirit, be a comfort to that family. For you said that you comfort those that are mourning, Lord. So we are just standing on that promise for that family, especially during this tough time right now, Lord. We're praying for healing for Tim, Lord. Praying for Carmela and her children. And we're praying for healing for Brother Hill's eyesight, Lord. Touch his eyes. Touch his eyes, Lord. We have seen the examples in the Bible where you have healed eyesight, Lord, that you have already done it. And so we have more than enough reason to believe that you can heal eyesight, Lord. So we're just asking that you just touch Brother Hill's eyesight right now, Lord, so that he can continue to be a benefit and a caretaker to his family and to his wife, Lord. And right now we're just praying for all the prayer requests that are coming in on Facebook right now, Lord. Lord, you know the prayers that are coming in. You know the requests that are being made, Lord. We ask that you just touch those prayer requests, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, as we look to you, Lord, we just thank you for this Sunday, Lord. We thank you for this day. We don't take it for granted. We don't take it for granted, Lord.
For there are many who are sick today, Lord. There are many who did not wake up today, Lord. So we don't take it for granted, Lord. We don't take this day, this time, this opportunity for granted, Lord. Another day to worship your name, another day to read your word, another day to try a little harder, Lord, to live for you, Lord. So we just thank you for these moments, Lord. We thank you for the opportunity that you've given us, the opportunity that you've given us to live this blessed life, Lord, to live this Christian life. You've given us the opportunity to live this life, Lord, and we don't take it for granted. We don't take it for granted, Lord. We thank you. We thank you right now, Lord. Lord, we just ask that you just continue to look over your children, Lord, to watch over your people, Lord, to watch over this country, Lord. As we continue to deal with the COVID-19 pandemic, Lord, that we continue to deal with it another week, Lord, another day. We just ask that you just continue to give us strength and wisdom as to how we can be lights in this world, Lord. How your children can be lights in this world, whether it's reaching out to people, our friends, our circle on Facebook, sharing an encouraging word, sharing a love, because the world needs the hope of Jesus Christ. And we have that hope. We have that light. And if we aren't positive, if we aren't sharing the positive outlook on the situation, where are they going to get the hope from? Where is the world going to get their hope? We have been charged with sharing the love of Jesus Christ, with sharing the knowledge of Jesus Christ, sharing the free gift of eternal life in heaven. We have been charged for that. But we have also been charged to love our neighbors, to love our neighbors the way that you say love, being patient and kind and long-suffering with them, Lord. Sharing some love, sharing some hope. That's what's going to make a difference in this world, is if your people, no matter what the situation looks like on the outside in the world, continue to share love, continue to share hope, continue to share the peace that they have, continue to share the joy that they have, continue to inspire people with your word, whether it's a kind text message, a kind phone call, whether it's a kind package that you send to someone in the mail, whether it's a kind gesture of going and grocery shopping for someone elderly, someone of one of the at-risk populations. Let the Lord use you in this time. Let the Lord speak to you and be willing to answer his requests with a yes, Lord. Whether it's just praying for your neighbors on your street. You may not know them by name, but you know them by house. You know the neighbors in the yellow house, in the blue house, in the black house with the white stripes. You know them by that. So just pray for your neighbors in your house, that the Lord would keep them, that someone would be able to share Jesus Christ with them if they don't know it. So we just don't take this for granted. We don't take this opportunity for granted. We don't take this time of prayer for granted. So we just thank and praise the Lord for this time. That it won't be the last time this week that you come together as a family and pray. That you come together and pray to the Lord. That you talk to God and share with him your concerns, your fears, and your gratitude. So we're just so thankful for this hour of prayer. We ask that you just continue to bless this service, Lord. Let your spirit continue to dwell in each of our households during this service, and bless the word as it goes forward, as it is meant for everybody that is listening right now. We ask that you just bless the praise that is going to continue to go forward, because we want to lift your name up. We want to lift your name and give you all the praise, glory, and honor. In your son's Jesus' name I pray. Thank God. Amen. God bless you, and we're going to continue to get our praise on. Let's just praise the Lord right now. Just clap your hands. Just tell the Lord, thank you. We thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. Lord, you're wonderful. You're so good, Lord. You're so good. You're
thank
so
you,
good.
Jesus. Hallelujah. bless your name, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We're ready to worship him. Hallelujah. Ready to lift him high in this place on today? It's Palm Sunday, y'all. Come on, get on your feet. Put your hands together. Let's give him glory. Come on.
Blessed be the rock.
Blessed be the rock.
Blessed be the rock.
Blessed be the rock. Yes, Jesus is our rock. There's nobody like him, nowhere, no how. I sure hope you got in on that praise today. Praise feels good on the inside.
Hallelujah.
When you let it out on the outside. Lord, we bless your name. We're going to declare and decree some things today.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because Jesus is the rock of my salvation. We're going to do our Start Right Credo, and I hope you read along with us there at home. Amen. The Start Right Credo is just Start Right's way of speaking life, using the gift that God has given us to speak life. Amen. So we're going to go ahead and speak life. We're going to do that Start Right Credo together on today. There is death and life in the power of the tongue. I will use my tongue to speak life and not death. I will use my tongue to bless and not to curse. I will use my tongue to create and not to destroy. I will use my tongue to encourage and not to criticize. I will use God's words as my words, and I will call those things that be not as though they were. I will call for light when there is darkness. I will call for faith when there is fear. I will call for healing when there is sickness. I will call for wealth when there is poverty. I will call for wisdom when there is confusion. Come on now. There is death and life in the power of the tongue, and we choose life. Come on and clap it like you believe it. Clap it out, praise it out.
Hallelujah.
Put a little praise on top of it. If you believe that on today, everything that you spoke, look, there's power in your words. That's what that verse is telling you. There's power of life and death in the tongue. And when you use it, those who love life will eat the fruit of it. Well, I tell you, I love life.
Hello.
Not only do I love, I'm grateful for life. Not only am I grateful for life, I have chosen life. Amen?
Amen.
And I hope you've chosen life too. If you've accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior and ask him to forgive you of your sin, you have chosen life.
Amen.
And there's a way to live it. And it's in the book. Amen?
Amen.
You can't just talk the word. You got to walk the word. You got to do the book. Amen. So we're going to get ready to get our hearts and our minds together for the word of God.
Amen.
It's for that very reason that we need the word. I love praise. The Bible says that everything that have breath ought to praise him. We ought to praise him. Amen?
Amen.
Because he's worthy of the praise. But you can't make it without the word, saints. You can't make it without the word. So let's get our hearts and our minds ready as Pastor Hicks is preparing to come to us with the word of God on today. And we're just grateful because you know what? It's first Sunday. And
amen.
I hope you saw in the slides, we are still observing communion.
Amen.
Pastor Hicks will lead us in communion. So you have a few moments to get your bread together, get your fruit of the vine together. That's your grape juice, y'all. I don't know about that. That was the other fruit of the vine. We're talking about grape juice, amen? So we're talking about grape juice. So we want to get our hearts and minds ready to observe Holy Communion. And to do that, we want to sing some songs of worship to the Father.
Amen.
Can you sing with us? How precious is the blood, amen? Just lift your hands. Lift your hands right where you are and worship the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Just
is the blood. Oh, the blood, redeeming blood, Jesus' blood shed for me. Oh, the blood, saving blood, cleansing blood from Calvary. Oh, Lamb of God, crucified for my sins, He bled and died. And oh, how precious is the blood. Oh, the blood, redeeming blood, Jesus' blood shed for me. Oh, the blood, saving blood, cleansing blood from Calvary. Is the blood. Oh, the blood, redeeming blood, Jesus' blood shed for me. Oh, the blood, saving blood, cleansing blood from Calvary.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, how precious is the blood. Hallelujah, that hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, that was shed for you and me. Oh, but even more precious is the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus, the name, the name, the name, the name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I thank you for the blood that shed from your body. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Father, we thank you. Father, we praise your holy name, Lord. You've been so good, so kind, and so merciful, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We thank you for one more day. Hallelujah. For one more Sunday, for one more opportunity. Hallelujah. To give you glory, to give you honor, to magnify your name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The buildings are empty, but the church is full of your power, full of your Holy Spirit, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank, come on, clap with me where you are. Hallelujah, where you are. Hallelujah, where you are. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Your home is the sanctuary. Your home is sacred ground. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you for your goodness, your kindness, and your mercy. Oh, thank you, Lord. Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart, Lord, let it be acceptable in thy sight. Why? Because you are my strength and you are my redeemer. I ask for all of you and none of me. I ask for you to think through my mind and speak through my vocal cords, Lord. These are your people who are watching, the sheep of your pasture, Lord. They need a word from you. They need comfort from you. They need peace from you, Lord. Hallelujah. And we know, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, all of that is found in you, Lord. So we thank you and we praise your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, let's praise the Lord. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Come on, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Repeat after me. Where you are, hallelujah, where you are, if you're not from Start Right, it might be something new. But repeat after me. I will open my mind. I will listen to the spoken word. I will read and follow in the written word. I will understand, hallelujah, how the word is used and explained. And I will use this word for myself. Come on, come on, a little louder. And I will use this word for myself. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. He that has an ear, let him hear. He that has an ear, hallelujah, let him hear. Come on, come on. Hallelujah. Text a couple of your neighbors. Tell them I'm ready for the word. Come on, come on. Text a couple of your neighbors. Tell them I'm ready for the word. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now, come on, come on. Let's just give them a spiritual high five. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, come on. I feel it. Just go to the TV and just high five me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We ready. We ready. We ready for the word. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We are ready for the word of God. Thank you, Lord. It's Palm Sunday. Thank you, Jesus. It's Palm Sunday. Hallelujah. This is an exciting time. It is the Sunday before Easter. Hallelujah. And you know what? We thank God for the technology. We thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That we are not going to forget about the Lord because we can't go into the church. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. No, no, no. We're just going to worship him more. We're just going to praise him more. Hallelujah. And folks talking about, oh, the folks going to get used to not going to church. Oh, I don't think so. Oh, no, 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 no. Hey, hallelujah. Folks is excited about going back to church. Hallelujah. Folks is saying, I can't wait. I can't wait till I can get back into the house of the Lord. But until then, hallelujah, we're going to do what we need to do. We're going to praise the way we need to praise. Hallelujah. At home, individual. Hallelujah. We can have Holy Ghost parties at each of our houses. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Ain't no party like a Holy Ghost party because the Holy Ghost party don't stop. Hallelujah. When this is over, you can keep praising in your home. When this is over, hallelujah, Jesus is not going to leave. He's going to stay there right with you in your home, and that's where he should be, right with you and your family. Hallelujah, in your home. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And so as I was preparing for this Palm Sunday, hallelujah, you know where we have been all year long, and I didn't see any reason not, hallelujah, to think about what we've been talking about and then relate it to Palm Sunday. So is this all right if I can just relate what we've been doing to Palm Sunday? Okay, amen. I see there's some nods right there. Y'all giving me some amens and some go-aheads. And so I'm going to go ahead. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And so what we've been thinking about or talking about in terms of Palm Sunday in relative to Deuteronomy chapter 30 and 19. And we know in Deuteronomy chapter 30 and 19, the word of God says, today I have given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and curses. And so now I call on heaven and earth to witness the choice you make. Oh, that you would choose life so that you and your descendants might live. And so as I think about this Palm Sunday today, I'm thinking about the choice that they were making when Jesus was coming. The choice that they were making when Jesus was coming, was it a choice for change? Hallelujah. Or was it a choice for Jesus? Because sometimes the choice for change is not necessarily a choice for life or a choice for Jesus. And so we just want to look at that and think about that, hallelujah, in that context of what we've been studying all year long. And so as we go into Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 20, the word of God says this. It says, you make this choice, hallelujah, this choice for life. You make this choice by loving the Lord your God, obeying him, and committing yourself firmly to him. This is the key to your life. And if you love and obey the Lord, you will live long in the land the Lord swore to give your ancestors, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And so, hallelujah, the requirement to be blessed is love God, obey God, and commit yourselves to God. And we know it. We've been taking this into the New Testament. And we see in John 14 and 6, the word said, Jesus told him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father. No one can come to the Father except through me. And so Jesus is the life that we choose to get to the Father. And guess what? You got to get this. God's word can only work for you if you are living for him. I'm going to say that again. God's word can only work for you if you are living for him. I don't care how many scriptures come across Facebook. I don't care how many times you see people say, oh, you just need to say this scripture and say that scripture. The word of God can only work for you if you are living for God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. And so as we celebrate this Palm Sunday and we look to the events that happened on Palm Sunday, we could ask ourselves this question. What choice did the people make as they shouted Hosanna? What choice did the people make as they shouted Hosanna? Did they really choose Jesus? Or did they just want something to change in their lives? I mean, did they really choose Jesus or did they just want something to change? I understand, things can get bad. I understand finances can get bad. I understand your marriage can get bad. I understand. But the thing is that you don't come to Jesus for change. You come to Jesus for who he is. Hallelujah. You don't come to him for what he can do for you. You come to him for who he is and what he's already done for you. So many people are coming looking for a change, but they're not looking for Jesus. Looking for a change, but they're not looking for life. They're not looking for a new life. And hallelujah. And new life is found in Jesus. You can't want Jesus to come in and fix your situation, but not fix your life. Oh, thank you, Jesus. John 12, we take to the book of John and chapter 12, verse 12 and 13 as we start. And we're going to look at a few of these scriptures in John chapter 12. Word of God says, on the next day, much people that were come to the feast, when they heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, took branches of palm trees and went forth to meet him and cried, Hosanna! Blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna! Blessed is the King of Israel that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hosanna is a word. Hallelujah. And that word has meaning. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. That word has meaning. That word means save now. I don't care what you're doing. I don't care what you had planned. Hosanna, save us now. We want it now. Oh, thank you, Jesus. You thought we was in the microwave generation in 2020. Hallelujah. They wanted microwave, but didn't even know it was microwave because they were saying Hosanna. They was like, save us now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. They thought Jesus was coming serving Burger King. They thought they could ask for it their way. Oh, thank you, Jesus, but it don't work that way. Hallelujah. Because this was 1 week before Jesus, hallelujah, went to the cross. Hallelujah. But these people right now are crying out to Jesus. Hallelujah. Save us now. Hosanna. Save us now. It's interesting, however, that unknowingly, they were calling for Jesus to do what he was born to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They was calling out Hosanna. They were saying, save us now. Hallelujah. But they didn't understand. Had no knowledge of Matthew 1 and 21. Matthew 1 and 21 says, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Hallelujah. What they were calling Jesus to do is what Jesus was born to do. Hallelujah. He probably was thinking, you ain't asking me to do nothing different from what I was born to do. Hallelujah. The only thing right now is you want it your way, but I came to deliver it another way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He was there to save them, but not from what they wanted to be saved from. Jesus was there to save them, to answer the question that they were saying, but not the way, oh, thank you, Jesus, that they wanted to be saved. It's so important to see this right now. It's so important. I need you to understand this. I need you to get this right now. It's so important to see that we can be saying something that sounds like it is agreeing with the Word of God, but still be far from its intended meaning. And some of us are quoting Scripture, but we are so far from its intended meaning. Salvation, when we receive it, does not save us from everything. I want you to understand something. Salvation, when we receive it, does not save us from everything. Hallelujah. For the Christian, after salvation, the goal is holiness through sanctification, not elimination of all our problems. I'm going to say that again because that was good. After salvation, our goal is holiness through sanctification. It is not the elimination of all our problems. And so if somebody told you come to Jesus so that he could eliminate all your problems, they lied to you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He was not there to give you everything that you want when you want it. Hallelujah. Even Jesus riding on a donkey spoke to him fulfilling prophecy, not fulfilling the desires of the people that was saying, Hosanna. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, let's read some more. Let's look in John chapter 12, starting with 14. It says, Jesus found a young donkey and rode on it, fulfilling the prophecy that said, don't be afraid, people of Jerusalem. Look, your king is coming, riding on a donkey colt. His disciples didn't understand at the time that this was a fulfillment of prophecy. Hallelujah. But after Jesus entered into his glory, they remembered. They remembered what had happened and realized that these things had been written about him. Hallelujah. We already talked about the donkey, but I want you to see something else in this scripture that we have to understand. There are some things that God does. There are some things that God is doing that we don't get the full understanding of until it's over, until God has finished doing what he's doing. We don't always get, hallelujah, a call from God saying, hey, just in case you don't understand what I'm doing, this is what it is. Just in case, it don't make a difference. But during the time of what's going on, our job is to stay faithful. Our job is to trust God. And our job is to do our part. And we got to do our part no matter what's going on, no matter whether or not we understand what's going on or not, we've got to do our part. Can somebody say amen? Can somebody text amen? Oh, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to look. Let's look down to John 12. We're going to stay in John 12, and we're going to look at 17 and 18. 17 and 18. The Word of God says this. It says, many in the crowd, hallelujah, had seen Jesus call Lazarus from the tomb, raising him from the dead. And they were telling others about it. That was the reason so many of them went out to meet him, because they had heard about this miraculous sign. They had heard about the miraculous sign. You know, there are some that call on the name of Jesus only for what they think he could do for them at that time. So they had, they heard about the miracles. They heard about him bringing Lazarus from the dead. And they said, hey, let's see what he can do for us. Let's see what he can do for us. Hallelujah. So people want what he can do for them at that time. Again, as I said before, not for who he is. Hallelujah. Not for who he is. And see, a choice for change is not necessarily a choice for Jesus. You got to understand something. A choice for change is not necessarily a choice for Jesus. They didn't choose Jesus. They wanted miracles. You got to ask yourself that. And that's why we've been talking about what was the choice that you made when you start coming to church? And why is it so that so many people are talking about, man, the churches is closed, man. We can't even go to church. You weren't going to church when the church was open. Coming once a month or once every 3 months doesn't count as you going to church. Hallelujah. And it's not about you entering the building. It's about your relationship with God. And no matter if the building is closed, your relationship with God should not be stopped. It should be growing even more. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We don't just choose Jesus. I mean, you get some people that come to church. The only reason they come to church is looking for what they can get from the church. Hallelujah. They're not even there. Hallelujah. A week, 2 weeks, and they're asking for something. No, you don't come for what you can get. You come for who he is. If you put him into your life, you don't have to ask anybody for anything. If you live right, oh, thank you, Jesus. Everything that God has is yours. Thank you, Jesus. And so they wanted the miracles. They wanted to be saved from the persecution of the Roman Empire. They wanted a king. Hallelujah. And as I said, hallelujah, it's not just them. I'm not just talking about them. Because the sad thing is that some of us today, we still only call on Jesus when we need something. Hallelujah. It's a sad thing. Some of us only call on Jesus when we need something, when we want to be saved from our circumstances and our situations and from our financial hardships and our jobs, our marital problems and our health issues. We only call on Jesus when we need something. But when are you going to call on Jesus just to say, Jesus, I love you. Jesus, I thank you. Jesus, I praise your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Stop getting on your knees asking Jesus like he's some genie in the bottle what you need in your situation. Get on your knees in the good times. Get on your knees in the happy times. Get on your knees in the joyous times. Don't just wait, hallelujah, till you want something from Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And so now we getting on our knees because of the coronavirus. Hallelujah. There are more people praying now because of the coronavirus than they prayed before. But if Jesus was a part of your life, you know, in John 16 and 33, the Word of God says, these things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation. Let me say that again in case some of y'all who think Christians don't go through anything, and any Christian that go through something ain't a real Christian. Hallelujah. He said, in the world you shall have tribulation. He ain't talking to the unsaved. He's talking to the saved. He's talking to those who will accept him and believe in him and live by his word. He said, in this world you shall have tribulation. But then he said something to blow our minds. He said, but be of good cheer. you know, have yourself a good old time while you shut in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praising and singing. Hallelujah. Songs and hymns and spiritual songs to the Lord. Have yourself a good time because you know who he is. He said, be of good cheer. Why? He said, because I have overcome the world. If you live in me and I live in you, guess what? You've overcome it too. Hallelujah. Because this world, hallelujah. The only thing this world can affect is this. That's all it's going. And guess what? It was affected the minute you was born. The minute you was born, you was dying. The minute you was born, you was headed to your death date. Hallelujah. But we can be of good cheer because we know when, hallelujah, to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. Woo! Thank you. That's good news. That's a reason to be of good cheer. Thank you, Jesus. He said, because I've overcome this world. Hallelujah. Ain't nothing this world can throw at you that I can't overcome. See, some of y'all think, hallelujah, you know, some of us going to overcome it. Hallelujah, because we gonna it ain't gonna affect us, but we're not gonna overcome death, hallelujah, by just dying, but we're gonna overcome it when we open up our eyes in heaven. Thank you, Jesus. Because I am an overcomer. Hallelujah. You just say that where you are right now. Say that at your house. Say that right now. I am an overcomer. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I am an overcomer. Jesus didn't come to save us from tribulation, but he came, hallelujah, to help us get through it. Hallelujah, to be our calm in the middle of the storm, to be our anchor so we're not moved. Reminds me of the song, hallelujah, that the mothers used to sing on Friday, said, there's a storm out on the ocean, and it's moving this away. If your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't care what's going on right now in this world. My soul is anchored. My soul is anchored in the Lord. I'm not going to drift to the left. I'm not going to drift to the right. I'm staying firm in the Lord. I trust God no matter what happens. I trust God no matter what I see. I trust God no matter how I feel. I'm anchored in the Lord. Woo! Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm anchored. I'm anchored. I'm anchored. I'm anchored in the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. So you got to remember the reason Jesus came. Keep in your head the reason Jesus came. The reason Jesus came is to save us from our sins. The reason Jesus came is to save us from our sins because it is our sins that separate us from God. Hallelujah. And it is the separation from God that will send us to hell. And so even if you uneasy, if you haven't accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, if you felt the need to come to church, that ain't what you need. You don't need to come to church. You need to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior so that you can get rid of the sin in your life and stop being separated from God. Only way to the Father is through the Son. Hallelujah. That's what you need. Hallelujah. You don't need the church building. Hallelujah. You need to accept Jesus right where you are. Amen. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so you got to understand something. You got to understand something, see, because this was all God's plan. Hallelujah. God set this up, hallelujah, so that we could choose Jesus, so that we could have sin and death removed from our lives, so that we can be connected back to him, so that we can not only love God, obey God, and commit ourselves to God, but so that we could be blessed by him as we go through our trials and tribulations. Anybody being blessed, hallelujah, as they're going through trials and tribulation? Oh, yes, amen, hallelujah. There's a lot of us being blessed. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Some of you are at home and still receiving a paycheck. Oh, that's being blessed. Some of you, hallelujah, can go and just pick up some free food. Oh, that's being blessed. Some of you are going to get unemployment. So everybody's supposed to get a $1,200 check, hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I call that blessed. I that's something that is coming that is not expected, that I didn't have anything to do with, but hallelujah, God can bless us in the midst of, oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He can bless us in the midst of. Hallelujah. So as I think about this, and as I think about the things that I've heard people saying, and I've seen people written, hallelujah, talking about Christians and saying that, hallelujah, that we have no power because, hallelujah, we some Christians are dying from the coronavirus. I you know, the very idea that Jesus came, hallelujah, and the coming of Jesus, and that you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. The very idea of it, that the very idea that coming to Jesus saves you from everything the world can throw at you, that's a man-made idea. That's a man. The very idea that just by coming to Jesus, you can be saved by everything that's coming at you, and you won't have no problems, you won't have no concerns, you won't ever have no money situation. That very idea, that's a man-made idea, and it's false. Hallelujah, because Jesus said in Matthew 15:8-9, he said, "These people honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. Their worship is a farce, for they teach man-made ideas as commands from God." Nowhere in the Bible says that we're going to have a good old easy time just because we accepted Jesus as our Lord and Savior. In fact, it says the very opposite. Hallelujah. It says the very opposite. I want you to go with me into Matthew chapter 10. We look at Matthew chapter 10 and we go into verse 18. Word of God says in verse 18, it says, "You will stand trial." Let me say that again. It says, "You will stand trial before governors and kings because you are my followers. But this will be your opportunity to tell the rulers and other believers, unbelievers, about me. When you are arrested, don't worry about how to respond or what to say. God will give you the right words at the right time. For it is not you who will be speaking. It will be the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. A brother will betray his brother to death. A father will betray his own child. And children will rebel against their parents and cause them to be killed. And all nations will hate you because you are my followers. But everyone who endures to the end will be saved." Let me say that again. Everyone who endures to the end will be saved. There are things, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. There are things, hallelujah, that we will have to go through that will be worse than what we're going through today. This what we're going through right now is nothing compared to what's coming for the Christian. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And even though it's going to be worse than what we're going through today, hallelujah, we will still be required to live the life that we chose. We will still be required to live a life that's satisfying to God. And our salvation will remain because of our endurance. Our salvation will remain because of the life that we continue to live, no matter what's going on around us. Hallelujah. If you never had any problems, you would never know, hallelujah, that you really stand for God. That of the choice that you made, that, hallelujah, if I live or if I die, I'm going to stand for the Lord. If I live or if I die, I'm not going to let go. And nobody going to get me to turn my back on God. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So being saved by Jesus requires us to do more than lip service. I hear a whole lot of people saying a whole lot of things and reading a whole lot of scriptures, and your life is jacked up. I see your life. And you think you can just quote a scripture and just abracadabra, presto, change yo? No, you got to do more than just lip service, more than just calling out the name of Jesus, or more than just quoting scripture. Oh, yeah, it's good to call out the name of Jesus, but it's even better, hallelujah, to apply that word to your life and mean what you say. Hallelujah, James 1:22. James 1:22 says this. It says, "But don't just listen to God's word. You must do what it says. Otherwise, you are only fooling yourselves." You ain't fooling nobody. You ain't fooling nobody quoting scriptures. We see you. We hear you. We see your post on Facebook. You ain't fooling nobody. You're only fooling yourself. You quote them all day long. You quote them in your sleep. But until you take those words off the pages of the Bible and apply it to your life, you're not fooling nobody. Bible says you ain't fooling nobody. Look at 1 Corinthians 4 and 20. 1 Corinthians 4 and 20 says this, for the kingdom of God is not just a lot of talk. Kingdom of God ain't a lot of talk. It's living by God's power. It's living by the power of God. It's living your life the way, hallelujah, through God's power in a way that's pleasing to God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. God is good. Hallelujah. His word is good. Hallelujah. This is put up or shut up time. This is put up or shut up. Look, this is about, hallelujah, this is about looking in the mirror. This is about making sure my life is lying right. This is about making sure my words is lying right. Because this is only a dress rehearsal. This ain't even the real deal. You know, this ain't really what's going to be happening. There's nobody really persecuted right now because you're a Christian. Only if you're a Christian that's stupid enough to keep having crowds together and not listening to the government. But we ain't being persecuted. We still able to have services. We still able to praise the name of the Lord. We still able to praise the name of Jesus. We still able to have the services right on internet. They're increasing ways for us to get Jesus out. But when they shut us down, when we ain't going to be able to get anything through the airwaves, hallelujah, do sound wave, do nothing. They're going to shut us down, and then they're going to come and try and shut the churches down. And that's when we're going to be persecuted, when they come to arrest us and when everybody everywhere hates us because of what we believe. This is just a dress rehearsal right now. This is just a dress. How do you stand, hallelujah, right now through this tribulation? It's gonna see, hallelujah, how you gonna make it through the rest of it. Hallelujah. If you ain't praying and you doubting God right now, you're not gonna make it through the real deal. Hallelujah. Because the real deal, oh thank you, Jesus, the real deal is coming. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. The real deal is coming. Look, I submit to you today that we need to set our sights higher when we call on Jesus. When we choose Jesus, when we choose the way, the truth, and the life, because that's who he says he is. He says, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. When we choose him, when we choose to accept what he was born to do, not try to get him to do what we want him to do. But when we choose to accept what he was born to do, to save us from our sins, when we choose to live each day, hallelujah, that we are given, and guess what? Every day that we are getting now and even before this thing, it was a blessing. See, right now, we're waking up. I mean, because we're hearing the numbers. I mean, 524 hours on one day died in New York, and then 500 more the day before, and 300 the day before. I mean, it's you think about those numbers, man. It's a blessing to be able to wake up. It's a blessing to be able to wake up. But guess what? It always was. It always was a blessing to wake up. We're just being, hallelujah, we're just getting woke right now. I mean, really woke right now to what God has done for us and what he continues to do for us. And so as you take every day that you are given, live it like you are free from sin and death. Live it like, hallelujah, you know that Jesus was successful in what he did for us. Hallelujah. We choose to endure. We choose to endure whatever this world can throw at us. We endure because we have the assurance of eternal life through Jesus Christ. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We have assurance through Jesus Christ of eternal life. No matter what happens in this world, no matter what amount of time that you get, no matter if you live to 104, it's only a small amount of eternal life. So on this Palm Sunday, we say Hosanna. On this Palm Sunday, we say, Lord, save us now. We stand in agreement that Jesus is the name above all other names. He's the name above all other names. Even the name COVID-19, he's the name above all of the names. So as I get ready to go to communion, I just want to tell you, don't set your goals to just make it through this pandemic. Set your goals a little higher. Set your goals to love Jesus. Set your goals to live a life that's acceptable to God. Set your goals to make it into heaven. Because then and only then, with the shouts of Hosanna in 2020, will make any sense. Oh, thank you. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hosanna! 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 Woo, thank you, Jesus. Lord, save us now. Hallelujah, Lord, save us now. Hallelujah, Lord, save us now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, let our lives be lives that are pleasing in your sight. Let our light shine, hallelujah, to the unsaved in this world. Don't let us, hallelujah, act fearful and look fearful. Hallelujah. Being wise and fearful are two different things, hallelujah. But we're not afraid, hallelujah, but we don't tempt God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We trust God. But as my son said on the phone the other day, he said, but we still put our seatbelts on when we get in the car. Why? Because it's proven that seatbelt saved lives. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You get in an accident, you're going to go through that window if you don't have your seatbelt on. Thank you, Jesus. You can't blame that on the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And so we thank God for what he's done for us. We thank God. Look, the most important thing that we have is salvation through Jesus Christ. The most important thing that the church can offer to each and every one of you who was not saved is salvation through Jesus Christ. Yeah, we can give you money sometime. If we have it, we can give you food sometime. But all of that is going to go away. But your salvation will last you into eternity. Want what we have and what we can give to you and offer to you that will last you forever. Hallelujah. The church has to begin to rethink what we do. To rethink what we say. Hallelujah. To know that we are only here to do the will of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. So we bow our heads. Lord, we thank you. And we praise your holy name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your goodness, your kindness, and your mercy. Thank you for how you blessed us and kept us. Thank you. For those who have watched today, hallelujah, have heard this word, we pray that this word takes root in their hearts and they want to accept you as Lord and Savior. That they understand it's not as hard as some has tried to make it out to be. Hallelujah, that you died and you on the cross and that how you rose again with all power and you did it because that's what you were born to do. Save us from our sins. And so today, hallelujah, I'm not going to ask for a formal hallelujah invitation right now. What I'm asking for everyone to do is prepare at home. I know Start Right already knows, but if you're watching and you're not a part of this church and you have some grape juice or any type of juice, even if you have some water. You know, there was time Jesus turned water to wine. Any liquid you may have, just not hard. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. Any liquid you might have, hallelujah, get some water and and bread or crackers. Because what we want to do, and hallelujah, if we want to, hallelujah, take communion together. We want to take communion together. And so we're going to take it here, and you're going to take it there. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. And it's going to be just as if you were here in here in the church building. Hallelujah. As you're getting your communion together. Thank you, Jesus. Just keep the volume up. Take your phone with you if you need to. Hallelujah. Because I want you to listen to this. I want you to understand that if you're able to take this communion with us today, this communion is going to be your acceptance of Jesus Christ today. This is going to be your entrance into the kingdom of God today. Hallelujah. Because before we take it, hallelujah, for those of us who are already saved, we are rededicating our lives to the Lord. But for those of you who are not, this is your opportunity to give your life to the Lord. Hallelujah. And so right now, if you're going to take communion with us, hallelujah, just bow your heads right now. Just repeat after me, Father, I accept your Son as my Lord and Savior. I ask him into my life right now by taking of this communion. I ask him to, hallelujah, to forgive me of my sins. Hallelujah, to fill me with the precious Holy Spirit so that I can read your word, I can understand your word, and I can apply your word that has all power to my life. In the name of Jesus, I pray, amen, amen. And so what we're going to do when we take the bread is going to represent the body of Christ. The bread is going to represent what he did for us here when he was in bodily form here on the earth. And what we're going to do is we're going to be agreeing as we take it in. We're agreeing, and I want to be like him. I want to emulate him. I want to learn all I can about him so I can apply his life to mine. I want to apply his life to mine. When I take the cup, hallelujah, that represents the blood that streamed from his body for the remission or the forgiveness of our sin, hallelujah, I take it, hallelujah, in me, and I recognize that it's his blood that saved me. It was his blood. Oh, thank you, Jesus. It was his blood that cleansed me. It was his blood that made me just and made me presentable to God so that I could love him, so that I can obey him, and so that I can, hallelujah, commit myself to him. Hallelujah, through the blood of Jesus. And so as we take that communion today, hallelujah, you are either dedicating and giving your life to the Lord, or you are rededicating your life to the Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And so, as we are here, hallelujah, and we get ready. You get your stuff ready. Get your stuff ready. Get your stuff ready. Hallelujah. Because we're going to take it at the same time. We're going to take it at the same time. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You put the camera on us and you come down and take it with us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is a good God. God is a merciful God. God is a loving God. Lord, we thank you. This is the only thing that, Father God, this is the only thing that you said, do in remembrance, hallelujah, of your Son, Jesus. Jesus said, do this in remembrance of me. Hallelujah. Do this until I come back. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We're few. Hallelujah. We're few in numbers. Hallelujah. But we're here. Hallelujah. Because of the power of God. We're here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because of the anointing of God. Hallelujah. To do, hallelujah, what you have asked of us to do. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If everybody is ready, hallelujah. If you're not ready, type it in there. Hallelujah. Let us know you need more time. Hallelujah. But hallelujah, we want to take this communion. Oh, thank you, Jesus, together. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to his name. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Today and right now, we all, hallelujah, we'll have, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You have your bread. Hallelujah. Have your bread ready. Everybody have your bread ready. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. There we go. There we go. We have our bread. Everybody at home, hallelujah, you have your bread ready. Hallelujah. Jesus said, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me. Hallelujah. Let's take that together. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You have your cup. You have your cup. Hallelujah. We're raising our cups in the air. Jesus said, take, drink. This is my blood, which is shed for the remission of your sins. As often as you drink this, do this in remembrance of me. Ooh, come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. 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 Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. If you took communion for the first time, please text it. Let us know. If you gave your life to the Lord, come on, please let us know. Tell us this was your first time. This was the first time that you gave your life to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. God is a good God. God is a loving God. God is a merciful God. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. He loves you so much. He loves you so much that he gave you his only begotten Son. Whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting eternal life. Don't forget about the real reason Jesus came. Don't get caught up, hallelujah, in the busyness of church. Don't forget why he came. Don't forget, hallelujah, why he's in you. Thank you, Jesus. We thank God for each and every one who has been with us for this short period of time today. We just thank you. We praise your holy name. We thank God for our visitors. Our visitors, hallelujah, as we tell our visitors that come into the church, we're just thankful that you joined us and that we were able to share with you the word of God. We thank God for our members and our partners who, if they were here, this was the time that they would give, but our members have already given. They give throughout the week. They give before we get here. They give through the mail. They've already given because they understand that, hallelujah, we are still taking care of this place and this house, and we're still doing ministry, and we are still, hallelujah, taking food baskets around. And if any of our members are in need of anything, they know that they only have but to ask. And so we thank you. We thank you for your giving. We thank you that you have not stopped. We thank you, Hallelujah. We thank you for everything. We thank you. Hallelujah. God bless you. Those of you who have been on Sunday school, those of you who have been on Bible study, on Zoom, on all of the different ministries that we continue to have. It's because of you that we can purchase all of those things, that we can continue the ministry. And so we praise God for you. If you need anything, if you have not, hallelujah, reached out to us and you need it, please reach out to us. Let us know. Hallelujah, because we love you. And everything that we do is because we love God and we love you. Amen. And so we're going to get ready to dismiss. And hallelujah, everything that's going to be coming is going to be coming next on the announcement. So please stay a little bit after and see the things that are going to be happening this week. And as we continue, because we're going to be here the next 3 weeks, we know for sure that we're going to have an e-service. We're going to have this online service for the next 3 weeks. And so continue to give us your comments and your feedback of how we can make this better for you, because we're doing this for you. Amen? Amen. So as we get ready to dismiss, repeat after me. I have to live with myself, and I don't want to come to the setting sun and hate myself for the things I've done. Before I continue, remember to keep the Brown family in prayer. They've lost two of their relatives, hallelujah, to this coronavirus, hallelujah. But thank God, hallelujah, they were both saved. I know it's hard for the family, hallelujah, but it would be much harder to lose a family member if they had not given their lives to the Lord. These were stalwarts in the church, hallelujah, that loved God. And so we just thank God for that. We're gonna keep our prayers for the Brown family. Hallelujah. We'll continue to pray for Teresa Cook and the loss in her family. And continue to let us know all of the things that are affecting you. They pray for Brother Hill for his eyesight. Hallelujah. And we'll continue to pray for him in his eyesight. Amen. Amen. And just continue to let me know those things throughout the week. Amen. Lord, until we come back together, give me the strength to grow right. Give me the desire to stay right. And give me the boldness to help my brother, to help my sister, to help my neighbor start right. In Jesus' name I pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God. Praise God. Amen. 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 Shake hands with your neighbor. Hallelujah, because they've been in the house with you, so you can shake hands with them. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And don't forget, hallelujah, to just wave at me and my wife. My wife and I, we love you. Hallelujah. We praise your name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We love you. Hallelujah. And everything we do, hallelujah, again, is because we love Jesus and we love you. Hallelujah. You fist bump me on the TV right there, or your phone, fist bump me, and just go ahead and put something in the on the side saying goodbye. God bless you. Hallelujah. So we know, we just thank God that you took this time and to share it with us. God bless you. Goodbye. And we're gonna fade out in a minute. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord.